We got there, we unloaded, put our skins on, and skinned up a Forest Service Road about 4 miles into this beautiful basin. So, you know, 6,000 to 7,000 foot peaks on each side, about 10 inches of good snow, sun going down in the west, so we had good late day light. Having to run into two friends that were up there with a snowmobile, kind of doing the same thing, playing with power. And they actually doubled us around and got us high pretty quick. I think that splitboarding is going to have an amazing future in the culture of snowboarding. It's quiet, it's peaceful. You know, it's one of the better activities with the ultimate payout at the end. We're going out to try and find some good rideable soft terrain. West Coast has been in a bit of a warm spell. We've had higher elevation rain with crust, and we're basically in search of some good slashable terrain. It's definitely something that turns snowboarding into kind of a quest instead of just a dialed daily habit of going and riding chairlifts. You can pull up in your car, put your skins on, you won't hear a noise except for birds and squirrels and maybe the dog behind you.
Take a breath. When you reach the front door, try to pace your step. It's a new day, time to erase regrets and start living for the now, cause there ain't much left that goes away. Can't stretch and take a breath. When you reach the front door, try to pace your step. It's a new day, time to erase regrets and start living for the now, cause there ain't much left.
Another day creeps by, living life in the fast lane. A traffic jam and a master plan for curing a couple of back pains. A bad way to pave a role for my legacy. Still, I'll never let regret fill the vacancy. But something's basically making me think reality is make believe. We keep coming across perfection so gracefully. Now I can patiently chew at the bit, 'cause I'm